greetings in Jesus' name to all the beautiful saints of COJC, love pastor, Pastor Fred Matthews, and elect lady Allison Matthews. Greet you in the name of the Lord. Sorry we couldn't be there for your 11th annual homecoming service. What a powerful theme of the year of prophetic release. I know that God is going to do something very special with you all there. We look to see you real soon. We're still floating from the last time of fellowship that we had together. And I hope that you've been blessed positively by the association with the International Alliance of Apostolic Ministries. Now, as you go forward in the year to come, I know you're planning to do some special things economically. I know that, Pastor, you've talked to me about your desire to ask people to align their faith with yours to become Kingdom Covenant partners. And we believe in the vision that God has given to you and to Lady Matthews. And so my wife and I, along with our church, are partnering with you. We're pledging at least $1,000 this year to help you pay off your debt on your facility debt, that you might go into higher heights and deeper depths. Well, have a blast. We thank God for you. We look to see you real soon. Remember, I am COJC.
Feel them,
young blessings in the air.
Those seeds that you sow, it's time to come into your own. Seeds,
walk into your season.
I believe we're in a time when God's gonna bless.
All right, I'm here talking with our very first member, Sister Wanda Smith. Just talk to us freely about any memories that you have back when we were on 1700 Knowles Street at Greater Hebrew. Can you recall when we first met or some things there?
Yes, when we first met, Pastor wanted to change the name. Of course, I got upset. I said, what is this man's coming here to change the name? There was three members of the church. Two had left, and I stayed. Two stayed at first, and then myself and another member. And then after a while, the other member left to go with her husband to his ministry. Pastor came in, and he talked, and I liked the way he expressed himself very well. He was very articulate, and he knew his Bible. So many things the pastor had asked to do around the church, and me being the only stubborn member there, I was like objective to it. But pastor finally brought my mind to it. He wanted to actually change the name of the church, because after teaching, he taught us what the name actually meant to the church, which it was a Baptist church. And now I'm Pentecostal. I've learned a lot more from pastor.
A lot of people don't understand our relationship.
Okay.
They don't. Okay. But they don't know we are so close.
Yes, we are.
We are very close, and you've always been near and dear to my heart. And I think there are two things that stand out in my mind.
Okay.
It took from 2000 to 2004 before I remember our connection, our first real connection.
Okay.
Happened in 2004. You were working in the church and you were coming and everything, but I can recall preaching in 2004, and I walked back to the back of the church on Knoll Street, which my office was in the back,
in the
left hand side, that is now a bathroom.
Right.
But I remember you were standing back there ushering, and you said, I could call you my pastor now.
Oh, you remember
because,
that.
Because you never would call me your pastor. Right. But what took place for you to, after 4 years, say, okay, I'll accept you?
I don't know, Pastor. I think it was more listening to what you were preaching. You taught me that the love that you had was not just in the words of the Bible. It was for people. And people that felt like they didn't deserve the love. It was more to the fact that you, no matter what I said, what I done, you had a smile on your face and shook your head and said, okay, Sister Smith. And you go away, you pray about it, you come back again, and you just kept chipping and chipping and chipping and chipping that hardness away from me. And you were the only one that smiled all the time. And you still smile and just say, okay, Sister Smith. Anybody else would have gave up on me years ago because they say, well, she just mean. No, Sister Smith, not me. Just give her time. That's all you say. Just give her time. Give her patience. Leave Sister Smith alone. Just let Sister Smith be. And I got to thinking, I said, well, maybe he's working on Sister Smith. And you always smile. That's what really got it, is you smiled a lot. And you took me to the Word. I thought I knew the Word, but I didn't know until I really met you. I mean, really met you, and knowing that you was true to your Word, you stayed in the Word, you didn't do like all the other ministers that we followed. You go to the Word, you stayed there. You didn't transfer off and lived one way and then preached another. But that's another story. But yeah. That's what really made me say I could call you my pastor. Because you really hung in there, and I didn't think you were going to stay. I'm going to tell you the truth. I didn't think you were going to stay, but you stayed.
Well, I'm glad that the Lord called me. I'm committed to you because you didn't have to be committed to me. You could have very well said, I don't know anything about you.
Right.
I'm going with my mom or my dad, and I figured if you could trust me and give me a chance, I needed to trust you and give you a chance.
All right.
And that's why I love you. We'll always be close.
Always be having close.
All right.
I love you.
All right. And this ain't just for the camera. I love you.
I love you too, Pastor.
Praise the Lord, saints of COJC. I am so honored to say hello to all of you. I miss all of you. And I just want to say one of the things that I learned from Pastor Matthew's First Lady and the Church of Jesus Christ is that you have to dig into God's Word until it starts digging in you. If it had not been for COJC while I was in Asheville, I would not have been introduced to God. So I just want to tell you all, thank you. You are so very blessed. And if I had one word to describe you all, it would be amazing. I love you all, and I'll see you soon.
That you've invested a lot, but the return has been slow. You throw up your hands and say, I give up. I just can't take it anymore. But I hear the Spirit say that it's your time. The waiting is over. Walk into your season.
You survived the worst of times. God was
Angela Osborne, one of our first members at COJC. Actually, the Osborne family was the first real family that we had. Before then, we had individuals at the church, but they're near and dear to my heart because they were the first family that we had. Sister Osborne, and then you had Antonio, Nikki, Tiffany, and Stanley. Today, we want to talk about when you got diagnosed with lupus. What year was that? In 2005, you were diagnosed with lupus. Tell us about that. What happened?
I had a thing called pneumonia, and through my pneumonia, they said I didn't have pneumonia. I had a disease called lupus. I was like, what is it? He was explaining to me everything, and it really turned me around because I haven't really heard of lupus. And after that, I had went to, it was like a month before I had lupus. I had went on dialysis, and it really turned me around because it was like things that I couldn't do because I was on dialysis, and I had to tell my kids, but it was a really turnaround because if it weren't for my pastor, he had brought me through so much and told me so much that we was gonna fight this thing, and we fight it, and I'm still here, and I appreciate everything that he did for us.
I remember in 2009 when if we had come to a really rough spot with this, and the doctors said that you would not make it into the new year. And I remember the Lord telling me to feed you communion, Holy Communion, and to just speak a word in your life that your life was not over, and that not only were you going to come through that surgery, but that you were going to also see the new year. And I thank God that here we are, getting ready to bring 2012 in, and you're looking good. You're a very active member at the church. You're there faithful every Sunday. You need to come to Bible class more often, but you're there every Sunday. You're an usher, working hard. I can't get a lot of people who have no diagnosis, no anything, to work as hard as you are. But you work hard on the usher board, you're looking healthy, you're looking good, and I just thank God that the Lord has preserved you to go even into another year, and I just believe that the best is yet to come. Thank you for sharing with us. We love you.
Because I've been dipped in the blood of the Lamb. Yes, I hear the accusations of the devil, but I hear God louder saying, well done, my good and faithful servant. Thou been good over a few things. Now I'm going to make you a ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of the Lord. And come on up just a little bit higher. And that's what I come to tell every soul in here today. That as long as God has your back, it doesn't matter what the devil is trying to say. I'm begging to tell your neighbor, say neighbor, it may look bad right now. Say your family may be
the Spirit say, it's your time, the wait is over.
Walk into your season.
Walk on.
Walk into your season.
Walk on.
Walk into your season.
Walk on.
Walk into your season.
Because you're in covenant relationship.
Walk into your season.
Whatever God promised,
walk into your season.
He will never, never forget. No, 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 no.
Walk into your season.
We're the seed of Abraham.
Yes, we are. Walk into your season.
You can go on in and possess the land.
Walk into your season.
It's yours, it's yours, it's yours, it's yours.